on your London. So I've developed this product so it only takes you a matter of minutes instead of a matter of days. What I've got here is just a piece of sugar paste. This is lovely, lovely fondant, we call it in the States. It's sugar paste. And because it's nice and firm, it's ideal for this kind of project. What I'm going to be doing today is I'm going to be making like a birch effect. And it's a really, really quick effect. And it's all you have to do is wrap it around your cake, so you don't have to cover your cake in advance. So what I'm doing here is I'm taking a bit of powder to roll it out. Just because I'm going to be rolling out a long strip of it. And we have to make sure that it will go all the way around. So usually I would get my measuring tape out and measure it. Since I don't have something enough. I'm just going to do it by eye. Oh, goodness. I'm not sure that's going to be big enough, though. And see how nice and long that is. Make sure it doesn't stick to your top. A little bit of cornstarch. And the shape doesn't really matter that much. You can always cut a bit off when you're done. But since it's a natural, it's a birch effect, then it doesn't really matter. It doesn't have to be really straight. Probably be enough. Now, what I have to do is make sure that there's enough cornstarch or powdered sugar underneath, icing sugar, just so that after I'm done working with it, I can still pick it up easily. Sometimes when you're done doing the work that you're supposed to do, that you find it stuck and then you gotta start all over again. So, now, what I have here is a bit of airbrush. It's spectrum flow. You can also just take a little bit of paint using a dust and a bit of alcohol. It has to be with alcohol or something that will dry quickly. Otherwise, you're going to be waiting there all day for it to dry. Okay. And I have a broad brush. It's a soft brush. And I'm just going to put it on really.
Ben's used a voice book. So
that's
a new
domain. Oh, it's new. It's got a seal on it. I'm just going to be putting it on really roughly. That's the good thing about natural projects like animals and trees and stuff like that. You don't have to be really, really careful. So, I get a little bit on my brush and then take off the excess and then just go at it. Okay. I need a little bit more. You just go at it. Just get a little... Very rough. Don't make it nice and even, because the effect is much nicer if it's very rough. As you know, birch is quite stripy. Oh, this dries really quick. This is great. I haven't used this before. It's really nice. Yeah. So just give it here and there. It could be a little bit darker, a little bit lighter. And then I'm going to go back with the black. Put a little black on there. Now you got to be a little bit more careful with the black because it's quite dark. And then, oh no, it's not. It's not bad, actually. It's good. More than that. Just get it really nice and streaky like that.
And use that to do marbling.
Marbling? You mean colouring your fondant and...
No, if you do a plain fondant in the paper and then do a marble design on top.
Yeah, I never tried it, but I mean this dries really, really quickly because you can really easily do lots of layers on it. Here and there, a little bit darker, and that's basically it. for the coloring. You can go darker if you want, if it's a design. Make sure it's not stuck, but it seems fair. Okay, you have to wait a little bit until it's completely dry. But with this, actually I'm going to start using this from now on. I usually make my own dust, you know, with Rejuvenator and my own paint with Rejuvenator and dust, and then it takes quite a while for it to dry because there's always some kind of like the water in the Rejuvenator. But this goes really fast. I'm really impressed. Okay, to make the crack, all you have to do is take a bit of the powder from the pot and put it in a bowl. Usually I try and get a bit of a smaller bowl so you don't have to use that much. But any bowl will do. And you put a little water in there. Now, you have to be careful with the water because if you put too much water in, you're going to have to add more dust. So what I usually like to do is take a little spoon and just do drop by drop. I don't really have anything right now. So I'm just going to put a little bit more than I would usually use in there. And just try not to put too much in there. Okay. You give that a mix. And then you see it's not quite liquid yet. Oh, shoot. I don't want to curse on camera. Just gotta give that a mix. And this is a bit too thin, so I gotta put more powder in. Usually I would use just like a dropper or something. Just a little bit more in there. Okay. Until you get like a kind of like acrylic paint. Like a double cream, you wanna kinda get that kind of consistency. And get that all nice and mixed up there. And get a little bit thicker. It will thicken up with time, so it will get a little bit thicker as you're working with it. So you just add a little bit more water. Okay. And then this is really important part to this is that you need a little bit of Crisco.
Trex
vegetable fat. You just need it to seal off the fondant because the fondant will kind of suck in the crack and it won't get the effect that you need. You will just have if you don't do any kind of Crisco or fat on top, it won't crackle because it needs to be loose from the fondant. If you if it just goes on there directly, then it will kind of sink in and you won't get the crackle effect. So all I do is, just with your fingers, basically, just put a little tiny, very, very light layer, light, really light, yes. If you put too much on, the crack won't grab. It will just separate. It will just kind of go off. So you just need to put a little, very, very light layer. And again, it doesn't have to be really even. Usually I'll just take a big brush. I have these really broad brushes that I use. And I'll just do that really quickly with a broad brush. And just get it all over there. If it's too shiny, you see parts where it's just really, really shiny, you just gotta spread that out a bit. And you can use that, you can do this on colored fondant as well. It gets a really nice effect. You can put down a layer of a metallic dust before, and then you will get kind of like a precious stone, like a opal or something. You get that kind of effect. It's really neat. You can also put it directly onto cookie dough and then bake your cookies, and the cookies will come out crackled as well. And it's a very strong base. You can also do royal icing on it. You can paint on it, anything you want. Okay, that should be okay. Now, I'm just going to clean my hands. Oh, we have a plug! Yay! like that. Make sure it's the right consistency. It shouldn't be too drippy, especially if you're going to do it on the side of a cake, which is also possible. You can just do it on the side. You don't want it to start dripping down when you put it on, so it has to be a bit thicker. A little tiny bit more. Okay, and then you load up your brush. And the most important thing about this is that you just go one way. So you don't go back and forth. And it's kind of hard not to do that because you're used to going back and forth. But if you go back and forth, then it will kind of ingrain into the fondant and it won't get the effect that you want. You can go a little bit thicker than that. And then you'll get a different effect than if you have a thin crack. And you can go over it again, but you do have to be quick if you want to go over it again. Again, this is a birch effect, so it's quite rough. You can put it a little bit thicker in some spots, and a little bit thinner in other spots. Once it starts drying, you don't want to touch it again. See, it's quite dry in here, so it's already started to set. Which is quite good, because it only takes a little while. Here and there, I want to put a little bit more in there. And the crack doesn't really have a strong taste or anything, it just tastes a little bit sweet. So you don't have to be worried about that either. That tasting a lot really strong on your cake. Okay, so you see it's already starting to crack there. See how it's already starting to crack all by itself?
Yeah.
And you could continue and put more on if you wanted, but I'm just going to do this like that now. I'm going to give it a little blow dry just to make it go a little bit quicker. Normally I would just leave that. Just go away, do something else for 10 minutes and then come back. But it's a very thick.
It's a heat gun.
I'm going to see how it works. Okay, cool. Just like a blow dryer, really. I'm going to give it a dry now. And you can see, if I hold it on one spot, you can see how that starts to crack immediately. If you want to accentuate the cracks, you can always pull it apart a little bit. But it's really not necessary. If you put a little bit of gel coloring in it as well, you get a different effect as well. It doesn't completely mix with the crack, so you get kind of like a mottled effect. Yes?
No, that one was done with a wafer paper technique, and it takes quite a while to make that. So what I have done is kind of simplified the technique into something that people can do in a matter of minutes instead of taking days to do it. So I'm just giving that a bit of a dry now. And if you have a little bit darker black underneath, you'll get that effect even stronger. It will be even stronger than this. And the good thing about the sugar paste is, even though I'm doing this, is a lot of other fondants will be too dry and they will start cracking and breaking once you want to put it on the cake. And the sugar paste will keep its flexibility even though even though it's dry. And it's only the top, the surface of the sugar paste that's actually dry. The underneath is still nice and flexible. Now you have your cake. Oh.
Oh!
cake ready?
And it should be, there should be a bit of trucks or water on it. Not on your cake. Buttercream on your cake. But on your dummy, if you want to use a dummy, there should be something that makes it stick. And then I'm just going to leave that for a little while until I get the dummy ready. And I'm just going to put some trucks on there so it sticks. Water on it is kind of difficult to get the fondant back off if you're going to do something else. What I'm going to do is very carefully, you don't want to touch this too much because it's not completely dry yet, but very carefully I'm just going to wrap this around the cake. You could do it in panels if you're not sure about this, part. You can do it in panels. I didn't make it wide enough. Well, there we go. Is it sticking? Normally I would leave it a little bit longer just to make sure it's a bit more dry, because then you get it all over your hands. But if you see, that's the kind of effect you're looking for, the birch effect. And if you look at that, got that? You put some wildflowers on top of there. If you look at that from a distance, then it looks almost exactly like a birch tree.
Yeah. Can I color it?
Yes, you can color it. Yes.
Any paints? Yeah.
You can use gel. You can use powder. You can use anything you want to color. Yeah.
$3.50 at the show.
$3.50. And you don't need nearly as much as I made for this. You need like maybe a third of that. So you would probably have enough for, I think, 5 or 6 8-inch cakes, 9-inch cakes, 20-centimeter cakes.
Question. Yes. Supposing, could you cover the 20?
Yes, yes, no problem. The thing is, you only have to make sure that this is a little bit thicker than that, because this will drip down. So you have to put a little bit more crack in there.
And that was just heat.
Yeah, you don't have to heat it. That's just to speed up the process here. So at home, you would just leave it. You would just leave it, and it will crack by itself.
Where do I get this from?
This is at the cake decorating company stand.
808.
You can put it on cookie dough as well. So you got your cookies cut out, and they're still raw, they're not baked yet. You put it on the cookie dough, and you put it in the oven, and they come out really beautiful.